I have a question for the Trump supporters out there. Are you trying to win? Is the goal to win this election? Because it just seems to me that people are just justifying everything that Trump does. And people, there's problems, and nobody wants to really correct any of these problems in this campaign. For example, Trump showing up at a black journalist event was not a good move, okay? He said that Kamala Harris identified as Indian American until she turned black. Yeah, a lot of you guys thought that was funny. But my question is, what about the people in the middle? What about the people that Trump needs to win over? That's my question. You can think something's funny, you can think something's true. And you may even be right, but even if you're right, does that mean that it's effective in getting people to vote for your candidate? Okay, he may have made that decision to go there. I thought it was a bad decision. At one point he was defending Vance. He was asked about Vance's comments. J.D. Vance was talking about how he thought that people with children should have more of a vote than people without children. It's a terrible situation to put your candidate in. The candidate was defending that ridiculous rhetoric, and he tried to say that J.D. Vance, he tried to clean it up. It's not a good look. J.D. Vance, his launch has been a complete disaster. And saying that, oh, I like Vance, I support Vance, that's not helping the ticket. You're not helping Trump. I mean, people have to be in touch with reality, okay? And Trump, he had that Chick-fil-A lady, a black woman, on stage in Atlanta talking about Kamala Harris and how she asked the question, does she really support black families? And she just went after Kamala Harris. Yeah, it was entertaining. She mentioned Willie Brown's wife because Kamala Harris had an affair with him. But my question is this going to be effective in helping them win? See, I think if Trump is on stage at a black journalist event, first of all, you're not going to win any votes from a black journalist event, right? If you want to get black votes, you're better off going on the ground and talking to straight up black people. Because these black groups don't exist to help black people. They don't represent black people. They represent interests of other groups and using black people to further their agenda, okay? The black journalists group, they're there to further a left-wing agenda, a Democratic Party agenda. They just use black people. They're not necessarily interested in helping black people. You'll notice that with a lot of these black groups. Not all, but a lot of them. Anyway, that aside, it was a bad idea for him to be there. It's a bad idea for Trump to be talking about whether Kamala Harris was ever really black, because he needs to be talking about the shady stuff that she's done as prosecutor. He needs to be talking about some of the crazy policies she's advocated, and he's actually put together some good ads, but that's where the conversation needs to be at. The conversation needs to be at policy, because if you make it about anything else, it's gonna hurt the Trump campaign. At one point, Trump was talking about Brian Kemp, the governor of Georgia, while he was in Atlanta, in Georgia, talk about how he's not a great guy, he's not a loyal guy or whatever. Again, it just makes Trump look petty. And it doesn't matter what you think of Brian Kemp. This isn't smart politics. It's not effective. It's not effective, okay? If you've got a problem with him, deal with that behind the scenes. You don't want to alienate the voters, because the fact of the matter is, Trump did a lot better in Georgia. Well, Kemp did a lot better in Georgia than Trump. Trump lost Georgia as a Republican. And Kemp won after that by 5 or 6 points, pretty easily. So clearly Kemp's more popular than Trump in that state. Trump doesn't gain anything from that. And then Trump was trying to he was asked about his VP somewhere else in Chicago, and he was saying that the VP, Trump basically said the VP isn't really what's important, it's the person on top of the ticket. This is something I'm hearing from these MAGA people, these Trump supporters, and hey, I voted for Trump in 2016, voted for Trump in 2020. I'm speaking to somebody who's just not a diehard Trump supporter. I'm just somebody who's just gonna tell you what I see. I spent most of my life in Michigan, Flint, Michigan, urban areas, around a lot of black people, around a lot of white people. I lived in Alaska when I joined AmeriCorps for a year and a half. I lived in southeastern Kentucky, rural Kentucky, extremely rural area, Appalachia. Similar area where J.D. Vance comes from. I was there for 9 years. I'm not saying I'm an expert on any of this stuff. I'm just giving you my perspective. And now I'm living in Georgia, in the Atlanta metropolitan area. Suburban areas, whatever. Black people, white people, I'm just giving you my perspective. Is this gonna help win over enough people in the middle to help Trump win? Because his base isn't big enough to win. J.D. Vance, he is a problem. Simply saying that, oh, the VP doesn't matter that much. That's okay, for the most part, that's true. VPs, for the most part, they can do harm. It's just a matter of how much harm. Sometimes they can help, but for the most part, they don't really help that much. They can't harm. Sarah Palin in 2008, she hurt the ticket. Now, I think McCain would have lost either way, but she hurt the ticket. A VP can hurt your ticket. And simply ignoring a VP that's hurting your ticket is not gonna help the ticket. Ignoring reality isn't gonna make it go away. J.D. Vance, the childless cat lady thing is a problem. The stuff where he's talking about all people who don't have kids shouldn't have as much of a vote as people with a bunch of kids. This is all a problem. It's gotten to the point where people don't like him on a personal level. Not just policy, it's personal for a lot of people. They don't like him. Outside of the MAGA base. That's a problem. People don't even want to listen to this guy. That's a problem. So I think the best way to deal with that problem, if you don't replace him with Tulsi Gabbard, somebody, a woman who's a great communicator who can actually appeal to independents and other women, actually get the effective message out there for Donald Trump. If you don't go with Tulsi Gabbard, replace him with Tulsi Gabbard, or replace him with Iowa Governor Kim Reynolds, or Elise Stefanik, representative from New York. She doesn't have a lot of experience, but neither does J.D. Vance. If you don't replace this guy with even Katie Britt, she's a junior senator, U.S. senator from Alabama. She had a disastrous response to the State of the Union address, but she's likable. She can help Trump. I mean, if you don't replace Vance with somebody like that, and I don't think Trump will ever admit he made a mistake here, so he won't replace Vance. My only advice for helping Vance is to utilize his wife. Maybe his wife could be an excellent communicator if she's a person who's likable, person who seems trustworthy, appealing. If she's that type of person, then maybe she can convince people that, hey, her husband really does care about this country, really does care about families. He may not always agree with the way he delivers the message, but he really cares. That could be the message there. She could help. I think having women vouch for this guy is the best way to get the conversation to change. Because right now, the Democratic Party, they're just putting out these videos, leak after leak after leak. Well, it's not really a leak, it's just public stuff. So once again, yes, Trump needs to focus on I replace the word mean with cruel. Cruel and incompetent. He's to define Harris as cruel and incompetent. Somebody said phony, that works too. He just needs to get focused on an actual message, an attack, or something that's substantive related to the policies, even though a lot of people don't care about the policies. Because if we don't get the conversation moved towards policies, it's just gonna be a cultural event. If that's the case, they're going to have Taylor Swift on stage for Kamala Harris, and it's going to be over for Donald Trump and J.D. Vance. So I'm just giving you my perspective. A lot of people will be offended. They will, oh, you're talking crap about Trump, whatever. I mean, do you want him to win, or anyway. The rallies, something's got to change. He doesn't need to speak for an hour and a half. I think 25-minute substantive speeches on what he's going to do. Like, for example, when he goes to Michigan, he can talk about specifically on how he's going to regenerate the industry in this country, how he's going to bring those jobs, those factory jobs, back. somebody had a really good idea. He can go to different venues for this stuff. That could be great. But he needs to get into specifics on how he's going to turn this country around. That's what it needs to be about. Bringing a woman on stage who designed the sign when he was almost assassinated. I mean, that's entertaining for some people, but anyway. I mean, is it effective? And if I'm wrong, I'll admit that. But I want to have this conversation with you guys. Because things need to change with this campaign, because they're not winning. And if you're serious about winning, you got to be honest with that reality. But maybe I'm wrong. Harris, she might screw up and make this about too much about the fact that she's a woman and it's her race and all those. She might make that mistake as well. But I'm telling you, if this campaign doesn't start homing in on actual policies, like what the hell is Kamala Harris going to do? I think Trump needs to be focused on, when he's talking, the border, the economy, cost of living, how it's going to help bring jobs back to this country. That's what he needs to be focused on. All this other stuff, the cultural stuff, I don't think it's going to help him win. And even if he sticks with Vance, he tries to rehab him, they will need an effective female communicator. They will need somebody like Tulsi Gabbard, who could commit to be a part of the Trump administration. He could announce her as, hey, she's going to be the Secretary of State. Tulsi Gabbard. Bring her on a campaign with J.D. Vance. Maybe she can say some, maybe she gets to know Vance and say some good things about him. Good things about Trump. Maybe he can introduce, Katie Britt or somebody else to be in this cabinet. I don't know. These are some ideas. He might, if he's not going to go with Arizona Governor Sarah Huckabee Sanders, she's a pretty new governor, so I don't know if she would. But being a governor, I think, makes you more qualified than most. But anyway, if she's not going to be a VP or anything, but maybe she can join the administration again. She worked for Donald Trump before. These are some ideas I think might actually help. So instead of getting mad when people criticize campaigns, let's have a real discussion about how to actually make it better if you're serious about winning. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.